Jib jab.
I feel like a freak, cause every time I pull out something to eat, for this week, I can't do this, cause I'm Jewish, and I can't eat bread. Yeah, my rabbi said only
matzah.
Any way you wanna eat it, cold or hot, it's
matzah.
Fun for your mother, brother, sister, father,
matzah.
Buy in bulk for a lower cost per box, it's
matzah, 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 matzah.
Hanukkah, no, that's over, so you don't get passed over. Get your ass over to my pad, it's Passover. I'm the mad flow, a smoothie teaming with the jibbin' jabbin'. If you want the story of Passover and the Ten Commandments starring Charlton Heston. But I got a question about the bread that is unleavened, causing indigestion, called
matzah.
Eat it for a week, we got stuh. No bread, no pasta. Best believe a Jew is stopped. Now Moses made the matzah when he was fleeing Egypt. Had no time for bread to rise, he said, I just leave it, we can eat it like this, feed it to the Hebrews. But little did he know that the week would end up equal, cause
let my people go
became the anthem. Get your damn hands up, maybe it will help you pass some. How could one bread rocket so famous when the taste is the same flavor of the box it came in?
Matzah.
Eat it at once, ain't no second guessing.
Matzah.
Leaving crumbs on my lap and chest, and it's called
matzah.
I found the apicum in my small intestine.
Matzah, 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 matzah.
Back on the shtick, we're at the Royal Exhibition Buildings outside, where there's been an enormous weekend here of thousands of people coming to see the Melbourne International Garden and Flower Show. And part of the show was a competition for a sculpture put on by the RMIT School of Fashion Design. First prize went to his father is Victor. His name is Tyrone Susman. Hi, Tyrone. I'm going to introduce you to Tyrone. And there are people just walking all over the place. I know it's been a fantastic event.
Yeah.
Have you been here every day?
No, I haven't actually. I came a few times and I wanted to maintain my sculpture because the flowers were dying, but I sort of gave up and just let it naturally progress as it should.
As it should.
Yeah.
And it's looking really good still anyway. And the theme this year was celebration.
Yeah, it was celebration. There were 15 of us, and my take on celebration was celebrating life after death. So all the products I used and materials were dead. So I used lots of fruit skins and palms and plants, which no longer are growing or alive. And I shaped them, reshaped them, glossed them, and spray painted them to give them a new lease on life. Because my concept was celebrating life after death, so that's where it all came from.
Which is a Mexican concept, comes from their indigenous culture.
Yeah, yeah, because the Mexicans believe that when you're on Earth that it's just a dream, and that when you die, that's when your life really begins. And so that's what my take for my aesthetics for my design was.
It's like the take of Passover. Or Pesach, where life begins after liberation.
Exactly.
Because when you're a slave, then you haven't got a life.
No.
And then you get a life once you've been liberated.
Exactly.
And what are you doing for Passover?
We're going to have a big dinner at our house, and there's about 30 of our family coming. And it's always an amazing, delicious meal. And yeah, I'm excited.
Yeah, it's one of the great things about Passover is getting all the family together and
exactly.
bringing it into beautiful.
Yeah.
What's your favourite spread on matzah?
It would have to be Vegemite, just classic, simple, Aussie. I love that. I also love matzah braai. Yeah, I'm a fan of matzah.
And so am I.
Yeah.
But 8 days is too much.
Yeah,
we have to put up with it.
Exactly.
It's been really great to have you on as a guest on the Shtick, and congratulations.
Thank you. Thank
Big
you for having me.
Big mazel tov to you on winning this prestigious award.
Thank you.
Because I think it is an amazing event to put this on.
It's pretty exciting. And as you can see, there's thousands of people here. So all the work was worthwhile. And people have gotten a lot of enjoyment out of it. So there we go.
I've enjoyed being here as well.
Good.
We're going out now with a little bit of matzah something or other. Pesach parodies, which are just completely viral on YouTube, so many of them. And we'll be seeing you next week for more Shtick. Until then, shalom.
In the land of the purple sage, where the Lone Ranger is all the rage, every year without fail, I return to the trail, and I'll do it till I die of old age. I'm heading for the prairie where the laws are dietary, 'cause it's Passover time out on the range, where a cowhand never joshes when he's singing the fear cautious, and cedar is held around a campfire for a change. Give me lots of yippee-yi-yi, lots of matzah, yippee-yi-yi. Let me eat until I've had my fill and get a stomach ache. Drink lechaim, yippee-yi-yi, with cactus wine, yippee-yi-yi. Even if we stuff, there's not enough, get them to rattlesnake. I'm heading for the prairie where the laws are dietary, 'cause it's Passover time out on the range, where bar mitzvah's a saloon that serves a beer with macaroon, and eggs are laid hard by kosher chicks, and no one thinks it's strange. Give me lots of yippee-yi-yi, lots of matzah, yippee-yi-yi. Loaded with gehakta buffalo, it's there for one and all. Drink lechaim, yippee-yi-yi, with cactus wine, yippee-yi-yi. Then you'll start to dance to an old square dance at the Pesach Matzah Bowl.